Hey everybody, it's Wednesday, May 31st, 2023. I'm up here at the top of our property at the neighborhood road. One of the issues that we're dealing with the homeowners association is that it's a private road and we are responsible for fixing and maintaining the road. This was nowhere near that bad when we bought the property, but you can see that the water is coming down this way and the water's getting trapped on the road and then washing and eroding all this out. So this has to be addressed. Getting bids on getting this done. There's a lot of water that comes from that way down. You can see where it's even washed out there. So this is one of the things I brought up at our meeting that we need to get fixed sooner than later. I'm trying to really figure out the best way to fix this. I think the best thing to do would be to cut this, put a new miter dent on it. We've got several quotes. A couple people have said that's the best thing to do. A couple people said, no, just fill it in with rock and, if you're trying to save a little bit of money, keep going. So, the other issue is that this one, I don't know if we can see it, but it's partially collapsed down there now. When I was looking at this with one of the other guys that owns property here, it's folded as if something fell on it a long time ago, not like it rusted and collapsed. So his guess is, and I'm going to say he's probably right, is when they designed this and developed it, they probably put in this culvert that was damaged, put the top end up, that way it didn't help with drainage or hurt with drainage, and it probably didn't pass inspection. And once that happened, they probably had to put a second culvert in versus removing one. Be my only guess. I have no idea. But either way, it needs to be addressed. What I'm doing today is cutting these trees back. That way we can get in there and make sure we got the right water flow. But then we're going to, like I said, still working on quotes to get that fixed. This side's almost as bad, but at least concrete's still intact, but you can see where the water is washed over this road. And then this is the storm water that goes down our property and across. It's not too bad, but again, somebody drives a horse trailer over the side of this thing, we're going to be responsible for it. The other main reason I'm doing this, again, my own benefit, is to document that I did not do damage to the fence while I'm cutting these limbs out of here. You can see over here where the tree has grown into the fence. Pretty wild. Maintain your trees, people. We'll take a good look at this once I'm done getting it all cleaned up. About an hour after work, maybe closer to 2 hours with hauling all the debris away. That's what it looks like now, so it should be a lot easier for the lawn care people to actually maintain this now. But also, this is where the storm water comes from. If you follow this hill all the way up, this storm ditch is for a pond that's at the top of the property. That's owned by David Barrett. So basically when that pond gets full, I guess this is its overflow. And then it goes that way again onto our property. But at least in order to get these culverts repaired, I've now cleared all this stuff out. Obviously haven't done any more damage to the fence, but looks a lot better. Up here near the area where we're going to build the house, we were able again to borrow that dump trailer over the weekend. We got about a dozen, maybe 14 loads of the horse manure dumped out here. So what we got to do, it's really just compost. So it's stuff from the horse stall. So there's hay and everything, who knows what else in it. But anyways, it's good compost. It's free. We just had to drive up there and get it with the dump trailer. So we spread it randomly throughout the property where we needed it. You guys have seen what I've called my crop circles back there. This is one, a small one that was here. This is one of the first ones I kind of knocked down because we were trying to figure out where things were going. And then up there was the original, I guess, burn pile for this whole place. So we continued to use that as our burn pile for the, I don't know, past 8 months. Finally decided to start cleaning it up. So I got some fill dirt there to use for my culvert back here once I know it's good. And then we dumped some manure there. So we'll spread that out. And then we'll get my good friend Ed out here to dump some crushed concrete, either maybe not through here because, well, with the house going up here, I don't want to put any work or money into the road just to have it destroyed when we start building and running power lines and water and all that mess. So anyways, we're about to get a little bit of rain, which is good. It's been pretty dry here, but I don't think we're going to get enough rain to test my culvert. But it is going to water all this down. It dried up enough where I could come out here with the chain harrow and smooth all that out. And then there's a little ditch here alongside the road. It's got to be a little bit more defined, but it's been tricky because it's been really wet and kind of swampy. So I've kind of got it formed. I still don't know if this culvert's going to be big enough. But again, it's just that this area holds water. It's not like a lot of water comes here. It's just a low spot that needs to go from here to there. And this whole area was a low spot. So when I put the driveway there, it was obvious that water was going to run across there. So now that I know this is where our driveway is going, I took some of those big pieces of concrete, kind of built a retaining wall here, but I didn't really go too crazy because if I do have to put in a bigger culvert, then I can just easily move the rocks and it's really only a couple hours worth of work wasted, but need a good rain again to make sure that works. This side over here is flowing perfect. What even another guy said when he came out here to look at it is you really don't want it like a creek. You want it a creek and then a puddle and then a creek and then a puddle because it slows down the movement of water. So that is what's happening, but it's not puddling up much. There's a little bit of a low spot here and a low spot there, but it just slows the flow of water. So this side I know is going to be good. It's just this side is still a little wavy. So I need a little bit of rain to get some puddles here to figure out where my low spots are. Some are pretty obvious, some aren't. But then I can get this. I don't even know if I'll seed it because all that growth is going to come right back. But I might throw something on there just to hold the dirt. But that's coming along good up over here. We planted our falling cypress. Our falling water's bald cypress. Yeah, never heard of one before. This guy's pretty cool. We were in a silent auction at the 4-H, what do you call it? Extension office. So we won this guy. He was pretty cool. Never seen one before, but it's a falling water's bald cypress. This storm ditch is obviously doing great. We put another big bald cypress right there, trying to restore this area, but we got to get the water moving where we need it to first. And then now that we should be done with Ed Barber dumping off big loads of stuff for a little while, we planted that DOT mix from Hancock Seed here, and it's already starting to really look good. It even looks better, you know, with your eyes versus on the camera. Coming over here, this is another area we spread the compost. Emily did a great job doing that. Got grass seed on it Sunday. Been trying to water it a little bit just to get it there. Nothing's really germinating yet, but looks like it's about close because it's greener than it was 2 days ago. Over here, this storm ditch. I really probably should have put some compost on here, but I got excited, I guess, and put seed on it, but this was pretty nutrient rich soil anyways because we had that winter rye on here, so it's decomposed, plus the dirt that I put in here was from way down there in the property where we had one of our other crop circles. But anyways, this is looking pretty good, so hopefully we get a little more rain out here at Deer Run Farm.